बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम एंड अस्सलाम वालेकुम। यू आर वाचिंग टू वेटनरी साइंस फॉर यू चैनल विद डॉक्टर मोहम्मद इल्ताफ हुसैन। इफ़ यू आर न्यू ऑन माय चैनल सो सब्सक्राइब द चैनल एंड क्लिक द बेल आइकन टू रिसीव मोर सच इन्फॉर्मेटिव एंड न्यू वीडियोस रिलेटेड टू वेटनरी एंड एनिमल साइंसेज। टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस मिल्क एडल्ट्रेंट्स एंड टेस्ट्स फॉर देयर डिटेक्शन। सो मोटिवेटेड आर एडिबल एडल्ट्रेंट्स। द फर्स्ट वन इज वेजिटेबल प्रोटीन, एडिशन ऑफ वे, एडिशन ऑफ वाटर and milk from different species. These are edible edulcorants are motivated. The next one is harmful edulcorants. So formalin, urea, detergents, ammonium sulfate, boric acid, caustic soda, benzoic acid, salicylic acid, hydrogen peroxide, sugar and melamine. These are harmful edulcorants. Common parameters that are checked to evaluate milk quality are fat percentage, SNF solid not fat percentage, protein content and freezing point. Edulcorants are added in milk to increase these parameters, thereby increasing the milk quality in dishonest way. For example, cane sugar, starch, sulfate salts, urea and common salts are added to increase solid not fat. Commercial urea is added to milk to increase non-protein nitrogen content. Similarly, melamine is added to increase protein content falsely. Ammonium sulfate is added to increase the lactometer reading by maintaining the density of diluted milk. Formalin, salicylic acid, benzoic acid and hydrogen peroxide act as preservatives and increase the shelf life of the milk. Since milk fat is very expensive, some manufacturers of milk and dairy products remove milk fat for additional financial gain and compensate it by adding non-milk fat such as vegetable oil. Detergents are added to emulsify and dissolve the oil in water, giving a frothy solution, which is the desired characteristics of milk. Harmful effects of edulcorants. So the first one is melamine at levels above the safety limit can induce renal failure and death in infants. The second one is both peroxides and detergents in milk can cause gastrointestinal complications, which can lead to gastritis and inflammation of the intestine. The third one is excessive starch in the milk can cause diarrhea due to the effects of undigested starch in colon. However, accumulated starch in the body may prove very fatal for diabetic patients. The fourth one, urea in milk overburdens the kidneys as they have to filter out more urea content from the body. The fifth one is, in addition, carbonate and bicarbonates might cause disruption in hormone signaling that regulate development and reproduction. Methods of analysis of milk. So mainly the milk is tested for these edulcorants by two ways, that is, the first one is qualitative detection method, the second one is quantitative detection method. The first one is qualitative detection method. Qualitative detection of edulcorants in milk are sample color based chemical reactions. These can be performed in any biosafety level 1 laboratory with availability of chemical reagents and necessary precautions. Major drawbacks of these techniques are the facts that these are valid for a limited range of concentrations and are not sufficiently precise. However, qualitative detections are advantageous because these are simple, rapid and very easy to perform. Some of the edible compounds are often used as edulcorants to improve the taste of the milk. Presence of those in milk can be detected rapidly. Edible edulcorants. So sugar, the detection of edible edulcorants. So the first one is sugar. By taking 5 ml milk sample in a test tube, add 1 ml concentrated HCl and 0.1 gram resorcinol solution. Place the test tube in water bath for 5 minutes. Appearance of red color indicates the presence of added sugar. Detection of starch. So for this we take 3 ml sample in a test tube. After boiling it thoroughly, cool it to room temperature. Add 1 drop of 1% iodine solution. Appearance of blue color indicates the presence of starch. Detection of glucose. So for this, take 1 ml of milk sample in a test tube. Add 1 ml of modified Barfoids reagent. Heat the mixture for exactly 3 minutes in a boiling water bath. rapidly cool under tap water. Immediate appearance of deep blue color indicates the presence of glucose. Simple hazardous chemicals detection technique in milk. So for hydrogen peroxide, we take 1 ml milk sample in a test tube and add 1 ml of potassium iodide starch reagent solution and mix well. Appearance of blue color indicates the presence of hydrogen peroxide as adulterant. Detection of formalin. So for this, take 10 ml milk sample and test tube. Add 5 ml concentrated sulfuric acid with a little amount of ferric chloride without shaking. Appearance of violet or blue color at the junction of two liquid layers indicates the presence of formalin. Detection of ammonium sulfate. So for this, take 2 ml milk in a test tube and add 0.5 ml sodium hydroxide 2%, 0.5 ml sodium hypochlorite 2% and 0.5 ml phenol 5%. Heat in boiling water bath for 20 seconds, a bluish color forms immediately, which turns deep blue afterward. Pure milk shows salmon pink color, which gradually changes to bluish after 2 hours. So this is about the simple hazardous chemicals detection techniques in milk. Now for the detection of urea, we take 5 ml milk sample in a test tube. Add equal volume of 24% TCA to precipitate fat and protein of milk. Take 1 ml filtrate and add 0.5 ml 2% sodium hypochloride, 0.5 ml 2% sodium hydroxide and add 0.5 ml 5% phenol solution. Then mix. A characteristic blue or bluish green color develops in presence of added urea, whereas pure milk remains colorless. Detection of nitrate. So for this, take 10 ml sample milk in a beaker, add 10 ml mercury chloride solution to it. After mixing, filter through it Wattman number 42 filter paper. Take 1 ml filtrate in a test tube and add 4 ml of diphenyl amine sulfate or diphenyl benzidine reagent. Appearance of blue color indicates the presence of nitrates. Pure milk sample will not develop any color. So that's about the urea and nitrate detection. Now detection of benzoic and salicylic acid. So for this, take 5 ml milk sample in a test tube. Upon acidification with sulfuric acid, 0.5% ferric chloride solution is added to it drop by drop. Mix it. 5 ml of milk is taken in a test tube and acidified with concentrated sulfuric acid. 0.5% ferric chloride solution is added drop by drop and mixed well. Development of buff color indicates presence of benzoic acid and violet color indicates salicylic acid. Appearance of buff color indicates the presence of benzoic acid, whereas that of violet color indicates salicylic acid. Detection of borax and boric acid. For this, take 5 ml milk sample in a test tube, add 1 ml concentrated HCl to it. A turmeric paper is dipped and it is dried in a watch glass at 100 degrees centigrade. If the turmeric paper turns red, it indicates the presence of borax or boric acid. Detection of different mixed adulterants in milk. So, detergent. For detergent, take 5 ml in a test tube and add 0.1 ml 0.5% bromocresol purple BCP solution. Appearance of violet color indicates the presence of detergent. Unadulterated milk shows faint violet color. Pulverized soap. So for this, take 10 ml milk sample in a test tube. Add equal quantity of hot water to it. Then add 1 to 2 drops of phenolphthalein indicator. Appearance of pink color indicates presence of soap. Coloring matter. So for this, take 10 ml milk sample in a test tube. Add 10 ml diethyl ether. After shaking, allow it to stand. Appearance of yellow color in ethereal layer indicates the presence of added color. So that's about detection of different mixed adulterants and milk. Now quantitative detection methods. So there are 5. These are the number one, milk adulteration with foreign proteins. Second one is milk adulteration with milk from different sources. Third one is milk adulteration with melamine. Fourth one, milk adulteration with urea. Fifth one is milk adulteration with other compounds. The first one is milk adulteration with foreign proteins. Soy, rice and almond proteins are intentionally processed into milk-like products and sold as milk supplements for consumers with lactose intolerance. Reported detection techniques for soy milk and milk are polarimetric method, isoelectric precipitation, SDS page, sodium, dodecyl sulfate, polyacrylamide, gel electrophoresis, HPLC, high performance liquid chromatography and immunodiffusion method, NIR, near infrared spectroscopy has been used for detecting milk powder adulteration with vegetable protein. Adulteration of pasteurized or UHT ultra high temperature milk powders with soy, pea and wheat proteins have been reported. ELISA has been used to detect these proteins with polyclonal antibodies. The second one is milk adulteration with milk from different sources. So for this, through mixing milk from random sources and different animal species is the easiest means to adulterate milk. Its quantitative detection is much more complex due to genetic and non-genetic polymorphism. Determination of geographical origin of milk has been possible using ICP OES, inductively coupled plasma emission spectroscopy along with isotope ratio mass spectrometry, IRMS. This method determines the mineral contents, inorganic metals and non-metals of the milk and identifies geographical differences utilizing chemometric techniques based on multivariate statistical methods. Cow milk adulteration and caprine milk has been quantified by HPLC, ESI, MS, high performance liquid chromatography or electrospray ionization mass spectroscopy. Indirect competitive ELISA has been used to detect cow milk adulteration and goat, sheep and buffalo milk. Adulteration of caprine milk with cow milk has also been detected using PCR. The third one is milk adulteration with melamine. Both the European Commission and the United States Food and Drug Administration, USFDA, have applied a maximum acceptable limit of 2.5 mg per kg for melamine in imported foods and 1 mg per kg in infant formula. Melamine is not only added to milk powder as adulterant but also in many other foods like wheat gluten, chicken feed and processed foods. Quantitatively, melamine detection has been possible using SERS, surface enhanced Raman spectroscopy. A portable sensor based on SERS has been also developed to detect melamine instantly. SBATR, FTIR, single bounce attenuated total reflectance, Fourier transform, infrared spectroscopy has been used to quantify melamine in both liquid and powder milk. The fourth one is milk adulteration with urea. So urea, being a natural constituent of milk, constitutes the major portion of non-protein nitrogen in milk. According to FSSAI Act 2006 and PFA Rules 1955, maximum allowable limit for urea in milk is 70 mg per 100 ml. Infrared near-infrared Raman spectroscopy has been used to quantify the presence of urea. LC has been used to quantify urea as adulterant in milk, a method based on GC or IDMS, gas chromatography, isotope dilution mass spectrometry, has been used to quantify urea present in milk. HPLC, high-performance liquid chromatography, has been reported to detect the presence of natural urea in milk. The fifth one is milk adulteration with the other compounds. NIR spectroscopy 1100 to 2500 nanometer has been used to quantify water and whey in cow milk. A portable spectrometer and commented that MIR performed better than NIR to detect the adulterants such as tap water, whey, hydrogen peroxide, synthetic urea and urine. Like urea, synthetic urine is also used in milk to increase the nitrogen content. In a case study performed in Brazil, urine was detected in all samples of UHT milk by following a chemometric approach. Presence of synthetic urine up to the concentration of 0.78 mg per liter of milk can be identified by a method using infrared microspectroscopy and chemometric analysis. MALDI, QTOF, MS, matrix-assisted laser desorption or ionization time-of-flight mass spectroscopy has been used to quantify vegetable oil and milk. So that's all about milk adulterants and tests for deer detection. So if you have any question, so you may ask through comments or through my Gmail, that is driltafvt@gmail.com. Thank you so much for watching.